guys, this is Comic Uno. Today I'm doing a review for Arrow Season 2, Episode 2, called Identity, which I feel is a good title for this episode, because we could see Oliver's kind of exploring his identity. What does it mean to be a hero more than a vigilante? We get that, to see that explored in this episode. Laurel's still hating on the vigilante, so we get to see the aftermath of that in this episode, or continuing of that in this episode. Roy still wants to be a hero or help the vigilante, and this is giving a little bit of tension between him and Thea. And in the end, we get to see that he is technically working with the vigilante to be inside the Glades, but promises Thea that he won't go out in danger, and she doesn't know that he is helping the vigilante. So we get to see that little Thea and Roy story. And then we have Felicity and Dig, who are helping Oliver, but you also see that they're more of a knit group because they're actually able to talk to each other. I think in season one, it was more that Oliver was telling, all right, Felicity, Dig, you do this, and they didn't really have an opinion because I felt they weren't as close friends. And with this, you could tell they're very good friends because they can talk to each other and say, you're doing this wrong, and I'm going to tell you you're doing this wrong. So we get to see a lot more of that in this episode, which I'll get more into as I talk about the review portion of this review. And we do have a cliffhanger with Laurel capturing the vigilante and saying, hey, tell you not to talk to me. So now she has the police surrounding the vigilante to try and unmask the vigilante. And the two villains in this episode are China White and Bronze Tiger. So we've seen China White a couple of times in this show. You know, she's been pretty two-dimensional. But Bronze Tiger we haven't seen, and we do see a little bit of them. I don't really know if there's really should been in this episode because they're more namesake than anything. They didn't really bring anything to the table. They're more just villain of the week. It doesn't really matter what villain of the week because they had nothing really to do much with the story. But yeah, they were the villain of the week. And we have some flashbacks that connect to today's story, the present time story, with the Arrowhead. They find these dead bodies and they find the Arrowhead that Oliver gave Thea in the first or second episode. So what did I think about this episode? I honestly really enjoyed it still. You know, I think season two, again, is just a big improvement from season one, and it's continuing to show that, especially with the characters. And I think in this episode, it's still proven that the characters are interesting and getting interesting with their arcs. Especially with Oliver, him trying to discover what it means to be a hero and have a purpose. And now he does have a purpose. And I actually loved the beginning of this episode because they changed the whole beginnings. Usually it's like, I have a hit list, so I'm going to mend my father's ways. And now it's like, I want to be a hero. I want to mend the Glades because this is my town and I want to. And I think with this episode, it's more Oliver discovering, how do I do this? You know, everyone hates Oliver Queen. Everyone hates the vigilante. How do I become likable to help people? And he's not doing a great job with it, but I think that's what the season's going to be about, is who am I? And honestly, if you watch my season one reviews, that was a big complaint of mine. I felt like the vigilante had no goal. So now that he has a goal of his own, it's not about the hit list and so formalistic, it's a better show. And I think they're improving a lot with Oliver's arc here. And I think one of my favorite parts, honestly, was the Dig and Felicity and Oliver interactions in this episode. Because Felicity's speaking her mind, and usually she doesn't. She's usually all googly-eyed with Oliver. It's like, okay, I'll do what you want. Usually, sometimes she'll say maybe one word and say, I don't really think, okay, I'll do it. That's what Felicity was in season one. And now in season two, she's like, you didn't even notice that Dig's been upset. You should be his friend. And that's what I really like about the relationship now, because they are friends and they can say that to each other now. And I think Oliver's starting to realize, all right, life is not all about me. I have these friends now. And I think with the island, he didn't really have many people interact with besides Shadow and Deathstroke, you know, Slade. He didn't really have many friendship interactions and very communicational interactions. I think Oliver is now learning, how do I become a friend? And he lost Tommy, and he wants to be good friends to the people he has now. So I think it's interesting to see Oliver totally not realize something's wrong with Dig. And when he does realize, he says, I want to help you, you know? And I really love how that friendship's growing, because I think that's honestly one of the anchors of this show, is those three people and that friendship, which I think will just grow, and hopefully they'll interact with, like, Thea and Laurel and all of them. I really hope seeing more of that. And I just was thought as hilarious that Felicity is now secretary, and she did not want to be a secretary and give coffee to Oliver. But it's more understandable, honestly, just to keep, I guess, his identity is like, oh, I'm going to the IT department. Why? So I think it's definitely a better way for him to keep a secret identity in the way he's having Felicity as secretary and Dig as the black driver, like he says. So I thought that was interesting. Now, what were the bad parts of this episode? I think really there are few bad parts. I thought it was a pretty solid episode. You know, nothing humongous happened in my opinion, but I thought the character interactions were really great here. But the flashbacks I liked, but like honestly when it happened I got a little bit disappointed when I see the flashbacks. I'm like, I want to see more of that present story. So I think they have to make the flashbacks a little bit more intriguing. That way, when you go to the flashbacks, you're like, okay, I can live with this. And then when you go back to present, it's like, okay. And I like the connection they made with this episode, but I feel we need to be a little bit more enthusiastic about the past story also, because I'm just not. When I go to that present time, I'm like, okay, I can't wait. You know, I'm into that story. And then we go to the flashback, I'm like, oh, go back to that present story. So I think they need to fix that a little. The villain's still not perfect. I think that's one of the things they need to fix from season one, and they haven't quite fixed yet. I think it will improve, but honestly, they're very two-dimensional still, and I kind of wish they had just crossed Chyna White. I know she's important to the Green Arrow comic books, but she's not that great in the TV show. And she's been here about 4 times, and every single time, she's just so two-dimensional, and like, why do we care about this character? She just seems like a white-haired chick who doesn't like Green Arrow, and there's nothing to her. We don't really have a background story, and she's been there more than once. So I think they really do need to fix their villains a little. And then Bronze Tiger also was just so two-dimensional in this. He's like, oh, I have claws. And I feel even though there's a lot going on with other characters, they could have given us a little background on exactly what they were doing. I know they were like stealing something, but it's just a very generic villain story. It's like, oh no, they're stealing something. Let's go become the Hood. I think they should add a little bit better of a story or just use a different villain. But hopefully we'll get better with the villains as episodes go on. And also, the one thing I didn't like, honestly, was the cliffhanger. I know a lot of people, I was reading advanced reviews and it's like, wait for those last 2 minutes. The cliffhanger is awesome. This is one of the best cliffhangers ever, or, you know, of the season. And honestly, I didn't feel that. I just felt like it was kind of a cop-out cliffhanger. We've seen this already in our Arrow. I think it was when the Detective Lance found Oliver. It's like, oh, we have you captured. So we've seen this scene before, and you know they're not going to find out. And if anything, it will be Laurel who finds out, who I don't think is going to find out right now. So it was kind of a cop-out and very generic cliffhanger. I was just like, oh, and I was very underwhelmed with the cliffhanger. I was really expecting something else with it, something more shocking, and I didn't get that. And maybe because I'm just waiting for something like the Black Canary, and that's something I'm just really excited for, is Black Canary and Flash, which I'm totally excited for episode 4 of Arrow, because we're going to see more of the Black Canary, and next episode we're going to see more of her. So I was expecting more of a cliffhanger like that. Honestly, when the lights closed, I was like, alright, it's going to be Black Canary, not Arrow, and that would make more sense, and it's just Arrow. I'm like, oh, it would have been better, I think, if it was just like this random vigilante saying, you know, do this and then escape. It's like, who are you? And obviously we know that it's Sarah Lance. So I thought that just would have been a better cliffhanger for me. I think that would have been like, oh my god, really? This one just felt like a cop-out. But that's just my opinion, but still a very good episode, you know. Both episode 1 and episode 2 were very good for characters. I really can't wait to see more of the story arcs develop. I think they're doing a great job with honestly fixing what they did in season 1, and that's what we're going to be seeing with these first couple episodes. And I think with episode 3 and episode 4, we're going to see more of that Black Canary story, which I think we're all looking forward to. But please tell me in the comments below, what did you think about this episode? Hope you guys enjoyed. This is Comic Uno and Dark Event. Oh, this is Comic Uno. Guys, don't forget to follow me on Twitter for Comic Uno and the Ryan Situations. And I'll have another hour review up next Wednesday, and I'll see you guys later. Bye.